Hello students, welcome to the class of pharmaceutical engineering again, and the today's topic is non-perforated basket centrifuge. And we have discussed perforated basket centrifuge in our last class. I highly recommend to go through that video for better understanding of today's topic. So first of all, this non-perforated basket centrifuge is a type of a sedimentation centrifuge. Now, as we have already discussed about the perforated basket centrifuge, if you remember, that is a type of a filtration centrifuge. Basically, there is a filter media also by which the solid particles is separated by the liquid portion. Whereas in this case, there is no as such perforated media. Whatever be the separation is there, that is just only on the basis of differences between the densities of solids and liquid. So that's why this kind of centrifuge is known as sedimentation centrifuge. Again, I am repeating, there is no perforated media in this kind of centrifuge for the separation of solids from liquid. And that's why it is called as a sedimentation centrifuge. On the other hand, perforated basket centrifuge is having a perforations in its basket portion, where there is a separation between the solids and liquid, and that's why that is called as a filtration centrifuge, whereas this is a sedimentation centrifuge. Now here you can see the separation is based on the differences in densities between solid and liquid phases without porous barrier, that we have just discussed, that these kind of centrifuges do not have any such kind of perforation media so as to separate the solid from liquid portion. So there is no porous media there, and that's why it is called as a sedimentation centrifuge. Now the bowl contains the non-perforated sidewall. As you can see, there are no perforation as compared to the perforated basket centrifuge. That's why there is no perforated sidewall. There is an intact solid sidewall is there. Now during centrifugation, solids are retained on the side of the basket while liquid remains at the top. So when this motor rotates, and over this motor this basket is mounted, as you can see in this figure. So what is happening here, when we start the motor, because of centrifugal force, these solids will be deposited towards the wall side of this basket, whereas liquid portion will be retained on the top. And that's why on the basis of this, solids are separated from the liquid. As you can see here, these black dotted and solid lines represent the deposition of solids, whereas these blue lines represent the layer of liquid over its top. This is an example of a underdriven non-perforated centrifuge. In this case, the basket is mounted over the shaft, not below the shaft. Regarding its construction, it consists of a basket, as you can see in this figure. It is made up of a steel or any other suitable material. Basket suspended on the vertical shaft, as you can see in this figure, and is driven by the motor by using any suitable power system. Now regarding its working, suspension is fed continuously into the basket. As you can see here, this is a pipe for the feed. So feed or suspension is continuously fed inside this centrifuge, and during centrifugation, solids retained on the sides of the basket, as you can see in this figure that we have just discussed, while liquid remains at the top of this solid portion. Liquid is removed by using a skimmed tube. What is this skimmed tube? Here you can see the liquid portion can be removed by using a skimmed tube. So in this way, portion of liquid over the solids can be removed by using these tubes. And when these solids are deposited at certain depth, so when we are continuously feeding this suspension in the centrifuge, what will happen, at the layer of solids will be continuously increased, and that's why at some moment we have to stop the centrifuge, we have to wash the solids, we have to remove the solids and start the centrifuge again. In this case also, after the solids are deposited at certain depths on the walls, operation is stopped. We have to stop the centrifuge after the deposition of solids at certain depth. Solids can be removed by hand or manually. Solids can be removed by hands or by manually or by any suitable scraping blade. Next thing is regarding its uses. It is basically useful when the deposited solids offer high resistance to the flow of fluid. In those cases, basically this non-perforated basket centrifuge is used. Advantage of this non-perforated basket centrifuge is there is a continuous process until the solids are deposited up to depth that there is no practical separation is there, and we have to stop the operation and remove the solids and we have to start the operation again. This is regarding its advantage. We have covered the principal, construction, working, uses and advantages portion of this non-perforated basket centrifuge. So this is all with the today's class. Hope you all have liked this video. Thank you, students.